जय हिंद, भारत माता की जय। दोस्तों, नेवर से डाई सीरीज, अ न्यू एपिसोड, अ न्यू पर्सनालिटी एंड सम न्यू लर्निंग्स। आई रिमेम्बर व्हेन आई ज्वाइंट फोर्सेस, व्हेन आई ज्वाइंट आर्मी, दे यूज टू कैरी अ टैगलाइन इन द एडवर्टाइजमेंट, डू यू हैव इट इन यू? सो फॉर श्योर दी सोल्जर्स, दी ऑफिसर्स डू गेट ट्रेन्ड टू पिकअप दिस एटीट्यूड ऑफ नेवर से डाई, बट देर आर फ्यू अमंग अस who carry these attitudes either by birth or they pick it up during their childhood. One such personality today is among us. His name is Lieutenant Eason. Let's learn from him. Let's understand and listen from him, his story, how from a non-Fauji background, he aspired to join armed forces, but could not continue. And what he did later was even amazing. He inducted so many in the forces that today we are proud of that. Lieutenant Eason, welcome to the show, Never Say Die. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind, sir.
Brother, coming to the first question itself,
sir.
You do not have any connection with the armed forces, but still you were aspiring to become an officer in the armed forces. How sir. And what motivated you?
I don't remember exactly when, but once in school, when I was asked for ambition, which is just a routine exercise to develop our English. So I had written that I want to rescue about 100 lives.
Wow.
So that is how it all started, sir. And one of the reasons that I had this influence was because of watching, documentaries and movies about special forces. So these were my early inspirations. If I have to sum it up, I have to say that if you want something very badly and you put your mind there, the universe will give it to you.
But the question is that you wanted to join army. And then yeah. Subsequently landed up in Navy. How did that happen?
The very first interview I attended was in Army. That was in the third year of my college. It was called University Entry Scheme. So I was an engineer and this option is only open for engineers where you don't have to go through any written tests. And I made it in the first interview itself where there were only two vacancies in the entire India and I was one among them. So I made it for UES 10 and I was in all Josh. But what happens are we get recommended in the beginning of final year. So we have another 12 months to go. And then joined subsequently. So right. During that time, I had a bike accident where I had a slip disc. So I wrote to them and they told me that since I had a call letter for the Indian Army Short Service Commission, I will be able to make it there. And I was all packed and ready to move to OTA, give my service. But unfortunately, the last week before joining, I got a telegram from them saying that I am short by 0.1%. In
fact, it is what do you mean 0.1%?
Sir, the telegram says the academic mark expected is 60, whereas you have 59.89.
I know.
So, it was a big shocker to me and I consulted a few veterans. They said that is fudge. 0.1 is 0.1.
Exactly.
So then I had no choice, sir. Then I had to attend the very next SSB and that was for Indian Navy.
But then in Navy also, you could not continue for long, I suppose. What happened there?
Sir, this slip disc of mine, it was dormant because I was not into any kind of activity and I was regularly into the physiotherapy and all that. But once you land in the academy, then you need to get into all the activities which you know. But more than anything, swimming took a very big toll, sir. Oh. Because once you're into water, your body is completely bent. Right. And if I start complaining about my pain, then I'm definitely going to be, sir, recommended for further checkups and probably they will relegate me or something of that sort. So I let it aggravate. That is, I think, one of the biggest mistakes I did. And one of the reasons this thing got aggravated also is because of that, because I was benchmarking with the Marine Commandos in my course. So probably Hosh without Josh was the reason. So at one point of time, I thought, okay, things are not going through smoothly, then better to quit and get the civil recommendation and, thereafter see what is possible.
So, after Navy, you joined a corporate house. You served there also.
Yes, sir.
What was that?
Sir, I joined ICICI Bank initially and I put in a good 3 years and thereafter in IndusInd Bank, I was an associate vice president last. In those 5-6 years, I was consistently met by a lot of aspirants who were recommended by some veterans or somewhere hearsay. They used to come and they used to meet me to get some guidance. What I never expected was this little bit of time and effort and energy that I put and mentoring that I did would turn into uniform, so soon that these chaps met me in a course of 1 or 2 years and with a salute. And sir, yes, sir. And they are, in fact, one of them even become a major, senior major and lieutenant colonel now.
So during this period, you found your passion automatically is actually that you can train, you know, the would-be officers, the candidates to become officers in the army.
Having cleared it three times is my only strength. Otherwise, which I am not a formally trained officer to, you know, sir, assess. So I am not an assessor. I am always on this side. The assessor is on the other side. So, so from this side, but I know how to push this chap and make him meet that side. So that was my strength. And number two is, it is all about building your character so that when your character changes, it automatically comes in the paper. So I started this academy. I felt, let me do a long-term training, which otherwise was not quite, which was not practiced as far as SSB training is concerned. Over a period of time, I started taking them with me for a lot of adventure activities, then rescues.
Would you like to, you know, narrate one best of your success stories, any of them?
One of my biggest success stories as on date, her name is Annapurni, and she is now posted in the Indian Army, but from a very, very unpredictable background. In fact, her appointment order contained a photograph, which nowadays the candidate's photograph is also there on the appointment order of Indian Army, has a photograph with her having a these jasmine flowers on her head. So you can understand what rural background she is from. In Tamil Nadu, for someone to make it from a non-Fauji background, from a remote area, and that too for a lady, it is the first in the history of Indian Army.
Superb. As you mentioned then, some rescue operations also have been conducted by you. So what is that story?
Saving lives was, you know, always in my mind. So it all started with accident rescues. And in 2015, the Chennai had very major floods, which was actually listed in the UN as one of the greatest national disasters. So during that point, there was this DG of Coastal Security, who was well connected to our academy. He was the one who was looking for a team to help him out with the area he was allocated, because there were shortfall of divers, people who could go into waters. So then I took account and then realized that I had three fellows who were like swimming in the sea from childhood. They are like from coastal areas, two of them fishermen only. And then a few other fellows who could get into water, I mean, get into wells, deep wells and all that. Then I got them tested. Physically, they were always good because that is part of our routine. Then I further got some advice from my own boy, who's a para commando, who was down there at that point of time. I said, please come down, tell us what it is all about, because he faced the Kosi floods, the Brahmaputra floods. So so he told me, sir, with what you have and what you're going to face, it is nothing. We started at 6 in the morning. And then I really don't remember how many sorties, but then end of the day, which was around 2000, we rescued 350 people, including six pregnant ladies.
So how many lives you must have saved by now?
750 lives. As on date, three major operations and seven to eight smaller operations, where again, we were engaged on request by the government.
Any particular story which is very touching, which you would like to share?
Really touching one was the rescue of a baby, an infant, 40-day-old infant, from a house which was half collapsed because of landslide and the other half was left, and they were taking shelter there because outside it was pouring. We took the one of the smallest life jackets and wrapped it so that, you know, there is no risk in any manner that we are going to take, and then brought it down to the boat and sailed through about 5 kilometers through lakes and rivers and brought it to the other end and delivered it safely to their parents.
So, Ethan, on one side, you know, starting rescuing the accident victims on road to rescuing in flood-affected areas, you have done so much of rescue missions. So, what is your message to masses?
It is an unwritten law that nobody can touch you if you do good. Because all that is required is you must give adequate proof and then stand by what you did. And I don't think nobody can touch you. Only thing is, off late, what we started doing is I had a person to consciously record. Even if I was the only one handling it, I did not have my boys around. I would call one of these spectators who were there only for that. I said, okay, instead of doing that, now you videograph for me. So I would have him videograph the complete thing and accompany me, and then put those, keep those recordings. Only if need be, I would give it to the respective authorities. But till date, nobody really asked me for it.
So, Isan, now because you have seen so much of life after coming out of the armed forces, do you regret that you could not continue in the Navy, or do you feel that this life is much better?
I decided to take life as it comes. So, like I told you, I took a conscious decision, so no regrets. Having commanded the Delta Squad so many times in so many risky ventures, I feel like an SF commander only.
You have done so many rescue missions and you have a variety of experience in saving lives. You never got any type of fear? Didn't you ever get any type of fear?
I had a lot of fear. I had to do a lot of analysis. I had to consult my boys more than 3-4 times to make sure that they are fixed on it. And then only I would take the call. But after I am there on the spot, then I don't know where the fear vanishes. We would just finish it. That's it.
Great talking to you, Isan. The way you are living life, the way you are shaping up youngsters to join forces, the way you are teaching them, the character building you are doing, the way you are making them a good human being and a good citizen of the country and of this earth, it's mind-blowing. Hats off to you.
Thank you very much for this opportunity, sir.
Take care of yourself. Sir. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind, sir.
So, this was Isan, and he exemplifies that the never say die attitude can be built up also. It is not necessary that you have to get trained in the armed forces to get that soldierly behavior and attitude in yourself. If you try, if your focus, if your aim is clear, your passion will build it up slowly and strongly in yourself. Just keep doing it and have that never say die attitude. Thank you so much. Till we meet again, take care of yourself. God bless you. Jai Hind, Bharat Mata ki Jai.